America is such a different sort of place to sort of play on TV and like radio. It's just so much bigger. We were like amazed by everything. The roads are so big and like the food is so good. I love the people and I love playing here. So just to be welcomed so openly, it's really heartwarming.
Yes, thank you. My name is Freya Writings and this is absolutely incredible. Thank you guys so much for braving the cold to be with us tonight.
New York is waiting for you.
We love New York so much.
I was definitely very outcast at school because I was, you know, I was a redhead and I was just taller than the other kids and I was just very different. I could never read music and I was really dyslexic at school, so for me finding music was kind of like an escape at school. So I used to go to the piano rooms at lunchtime and just kind of, you know, tell the stories you'd normally tell to a friend to a piano. But I was really lucky that my auntie gave me her piano when I was about 11 and it was nice and I could finally like play all the notes. So I'm very grateful to her for that. That's where I started pretty much all of the songs on the album and where I wrote Lost Without You. It's so interesting because obviously, you know, Lost Without You has definitely changed my life and I do really resonate playing it still every single day, but I feel like out of all my songs, I Think You Mean the World to Me is probably the one that still gets me the most emotionally because I wrote it about my mom when she wasn't very well. It was a lot more emotional than I think I was prepared for. I actually like cried on camera a few times, like not just because I was sad, because I was like in the song. It's nice to have Lena there to kind of talk me through it and just be like, it's okay. Yeah, I'm really, really proud of what we created. The first time we came here, we stayed in an Airbnb quite close to the Capitol building. And I remember looking up at it and being like, it's so iconic and it's so beautiful. And I was like, oh my God, I can't even imagine like being allowed to go like on a tour around there. And so when it came to actually like finding out that they'd offered me a deal, I was like, this is just completely out of this world. This can't be real. The time I thought that we would have was taken. Like coming into the lobby of Capitol yesterday and seeing this like the logo, it just suddenly hits you just how many legends came from that era and that label. It's just such an incredible like force of nature. It was one of those things that I for a long time just thought I would be a songwriter because I was so shy. I was like cripplingly shy and I couldn't even really speak to people. So I was like the idea of singing in front of a large crowd of people just seemed like ridiculous. And so getting to do it as my job just seems a bit surreal and really cool.
So pretty.
My dad and my mum played Carole King and James Taylor like religiously growing up. They all started here, like in this venue. To sell out the Troubadour from a girl from London who wrote these songs like, you know, in my front room. This is so crazy. I definitely feel like there's like this buildup of adrenaline. It's kind of like surfing a wave and you kind of like step on the board and you're like, oh, I'm gonna die. And then like you kind of catch the wave and you're like, still gonna die. But then suddenly there's a moment where you're like, it just kind of falls away and you're there in the moment. And especially when you get to play to such incredibly supportive crowds of people who have come because they love your music. And when people sing the lyrics, I'm like, it really like affects me. This is the beginning of a kind of like American journey in terms of like, you know, doing shows here and hopefully getting to come back more here and just, you know, say thank you and how much it means to me because this is way beyond my wildest dreams.